We come to the most important part of the PN junction behavior with respect to solar cell operation, a PN junction under illumination. What happens inside the PN junction when we shine light on it? In this lecture, we will focus on the depletion region and carrier concentration in a PN junction under illumination. The learning objectives in this lecture are to understand the impact of illumination on the properties of a PN junction. How does the illumination influence the charge concentration? And how the illumination influences the thickness of the built-in voltage and width of the depletion region? This schematic picture shows an illuminated PN junction diode connected through external circuit with a load. There is a current generated by a diode that flows through the load. By changing the resistance of the load, we manipulate the voltage drop at the load and therefore also the power consumed by the load. This PN junction diode represents a solar cell very well. By changing the resistance of the load, we can manipulate the operational point of a solar cell. We would like to achieve a situation when the product of current and voltage at the load is maximal. In this case, the solar cell delivers maximum power point to the load. We describe this case as the maximum power point at which a solar cell operates. When a PN junction functions as a solar cell, it can deliver power to the external circuit. You may notice that in this case, the current leaves the solar cells from the P-type semiconductor and flows through the external circuit into the N-type semiconductor. So in this case, the electrode attached to the P-type material is the cathode. This is opposite to the situation when a PN junction diode is in dark and under forward bias voltage. In this case, the dark diode current leaves the diode from the N-type semiconductor, so the electrode attached to the N-type semiconductor is the cathode. There is a schematic circuit representation or symbol of an illuminated PN junction diode at the bottom of the slide. This is a symbol of an ideal solar cell. One part of the symbol is a PN junction diode that operates in dark. Its current is labeled ID here. However, there is also a current source that represents a photocurrent generated by the solar cell. Its current is labeled IL. The resulting current flowing through the solar cell and external circuit is a sum of these two currents that, as you can see, oppose each other. Now, let's discuss how this photocurrent is generated. Again, we start with a PN junction at thermal equilibrium. Thermal equilibrium means there is no external perturbation on a PN junction diode, such as illumination or applied voltage. At thermal equilibrium, the diffusion of electrons and holes across the junction is fully compensated by the drift of electrons and holes across the depletion region. When we illuminate a PN junction, some of the incident photons are absorbed by a semiconductor material. The absorption of photons results in a generation of extra charge carriers that change the carrier concentration in the junction. To have an idea how many extra charge carriers are created when a PN junction is illuminated, for example by sunlight, I put some numbers that characterize the carrier concentrations at thermal equilibrium. These are the same numbers we have used in previous videos to characterize a PN junction. So let's see what happens when we illuminate the PN junction. The PN junction is illuminated with photons of different energies. The absorption coefficient of semiconductor materials is dependent on the energy of photons. Usually, the absorption coefficient is high for photons with high energy and low for low energy photons. This means that high-energy photons, shown here as blue photons, are absorbed close to the surface of the semiconductor, while lower-energy photons, such as the red photons shown here, penetrate deeper in the material. For simplicity, let's assume that the p-n junction is illuminated in such a way that there is a uniform generation of electron-hole pairs across the p-n junction. Generation of electron-hole pairs are represented here by the orange explosions. Here are some numbers for you to picture what's going on in a p-n junction under illumination. Let's assume a uniform generation rate through the p-n junction, which is 10 to the power of 20 electron hole pairs per cubic centimeter per second. We assume that we have a material of good electronic quality. This is reflected by the lifetime of the charge carriers equal to 0.1 milliseconds. We assume that electrons and holes have the same lifetime. From the generation rate and the lifetime of the carriers, we can calculate the concentration of photogenerated electrons and holes. Here we denote the concentration of photogenerated carriers as delta N for electrons and delta P for holes. The concentration of photogenerated carriers under these conditions is 10 to the power of 16 carriers per cubic centimeter. This is also referred to as the injection level. If we take a closer look at these numbers, we can see that the injection level of 10 to the power of 16 is at the same order of magnitude or at a lower order of magnitude than the original concentration of majority carriers. The hole concentration in the p-type region is 10 to the 16, and the electron concentration in the n-type region is 10 to the 18 carriers per cubic centimeter. This means that adding 10 to the 16 more carriers does not significantly alter the concentration of majority carriers. Minority carriers, on the other hand, are at 12 to 14 orders of magnitude below the injection level. This means that adding carriers through illumination will significantly influence the minority carrier concentration while essentially leaving the majority carrier concentration unchanged. Under uniform photogeneration condition, generation of carriers can occur in the depletion region as well as in the quasi-neutral regions. The carriers generated in the quasi-neutral regions will move around through diffusion. Holes and electrons generated in the depletion region will be swept to the p-type and n-type regions respectively due to the drift caused by the internal electric field. The electrons and holes in the quasi-neutral regions that are close enough to the depletion region will eventually reach the depletion region. Here they will experience electrical force that will act on them. Again, electrons that reach the depletion region will move to the N side and holes to the P side. As the minority carriers at the depletion region are swept away, this decreases the concentration of these carriers at the edge. This induces a concentration gradient, and minority carriers further away from the depletion region will diffuse towards the depletion region and eventually continue to be swept away. In general, only the photogenerated minority charge carriers that are within the diffusion length from the depletion region edge will be drifted across the depletion region. Ln is the diffusion length of electrons in the p-type region, and Lp is the diffusion length of holes in the n-type region. The minority carriers generated far away from the edges of the depletion region will recombine before reaching the depletion region. So, due to an enormous increase in the concentration of minority charge carriers, the drift current across the depletion region will increase. Electrons will be pushed from the p-type region to the n-type region, and holes the other way around, from the n-type region to the p-type region. You can imagine that a drift current of photogenerated minority carriers across the depletion region will not increase indefinitely, but will reach a steady state. The collection of photogenerated minority carriers in the regions where they become majority carriers is increasing the concentration of majority carriers above the equilibrium value. A system, in our case the PN junction diode, tends to go back to the original state, so at a certain moment the diffusion of majority carriers will balance the increased drift across the depletion region. At steady state, however, the concentration of majority carriers exceeds the equilibrium value. It means that the concentration of negatively charged electrons in the n-type quasi-neutral region is not anymore compensated by the ionized donors. Similarly, the concentration of positive charged holes in the p-type quasi-neutral region is not anymore compensated by the ionized acceptors. The average energy of electrons is expressed by the position of electron quasi-Fermi level and will be higher at the electrode attached to the n-type region with respect to the electrode attached to the p-type region. The buildup of positive and negative charge in the opposite quasi-neutral regions generates an electrochemical potential difference between the electrodes attached to the p-n junction under illumination. This generation of photovoltage, that is called open circuit voltage, is the consequence of the photovoltaic effect as we mentioned before. To summarize, at a steady state, the drift current of photogenerated minority carriers is balanced by the diffusion of the majority carriers across the depletion region. This is a result of narrowing the depletion region and a smaller potential difference across the depletion region. However, the n-type region and the p-type region become negatively and positively charged with respect to each other, and there is an electrochemical potential difference between these two regions. When there is no external electrical contact between the electrodes attached to n-type and p-type regions, or when the resistance of the load in the external circuit is infinite, there is no current flowing in the external circuit. We call this situation that the p-n junction diode is in the open circuit condition. Under open circuit condition, we measure the open circuit voltage between the electrodes that represents the difference of electrochemical potential of electrons at the electrodes. Inside the diode, there is a steady state that is characterized by generation and recombination of photogenerated charge carriers and the balance between the diffusion currents of majority carriers and the drift currents of photogenerated minority carriers across the depletion region. When we connect the p-type and n-type region together with a good conductor, we create a short circuit condition. In this case, electrons will move from the n-type region via the external circuit to the p-type region. The electrons flow from the region where they have a higher energy to the region where they will be at a lower energy. So now you understand what happens when a p-n junction is under illumination. In the following lecture, we will see the Venn diagrams and electrostatic potential of a p-n junction under illumination in different points of operation.